Do you know that you have emotions, but have some struggles how to handle them? Then you are on the right place now. Hi, I'm Jana Mendelova. I'm a founder of Health Connection Academy, and I'm on the mission to help 100,000 entrepreneurs to achieve independence using manifestation reverse engineering system. I'm a creator of Independence Manifestation Formula and Health Connection Mastery. Today, I would like to share with you something about emotions or something about our heart. As we will be speaking today about emotions, I will cover these four basic parts. Whether suppress or express our emotions, what are advantages and disadvantages of every possibility, then we will cover today the topic of shallow or deep feeling of the emotions, then changes between various kinds of emotions, not only the speed, but also of which emotion is changing into which one. And the last point of today session will be about prosperous and non-prosperous emotions. So first part is about the thing whether we should suppress or express our emotions. Generally, experts decided that it's better to express emotions, but there are also some people who say who are saying the the other opinion that it's not good to express our emotion all the time and in the whole depth of the emotion. So, what are advantages and disadvantages of both, and how can we handle these? First of all, when suppressing the emotions, or at least suppressing it partly, it may be good somehow for our surroundings in one point of view that they could feel it like we are handling or managing our emotions very well. But when it's not expressed and it's really suppressed inside the body, then after some time it can cause various health problems. There are various kind of approaches that will tell you where it can appear. One approach is, for example, that anger will be seen in the illness of the liver, then some sadness in the lungs, fear in the kidneys, and extreme joy in the heart, and a lot of thinking will appear in the illnesses of our spine. So this is one approach. There are also some others, but all of them can agree that if the emotions are not expressed in some way, then it can lead to health problems. So the other part is expressing emotions. When expressing all the emotions we are feeling right now and expressing it the same time can lead to the impression that we are not emotionally stable and that emotions are ruling our life. It can be true, and but not necessary. Advantages of expressing emotions are that they can't cause any harm in our body. But there is also a disadvantage, as I have already said, the disadvantage is coming from our surroundings. And also for ourselves, it needn't be really comfortable to express all the emotions in the whole depth all the time. So how to handle this topic? Again, you can find many recommendations. One that I like most is to express the emotion in some way. And it's not necessary to express this emotion the time it has started. So it means when you are angry, you can just use, for example, breathing exercise, as I have mentioned in my previous videos, and to calm it a little bit down. Oh, and later, when you manage to cope with the situation, you can express the emotion in some way that is safe for the surroundings, but yet it will enable you to really express what you have felt or still is feeling. So, what are the ways how you can express your emotions safely? You can either do some exercise, physical exercise, or it can be also running or cycling, swimming, no matter what kind, boxing, yeah, it's a good one. If it comes to anger. So it can be exercise where you, during the which you are concentrating on that emotion and put that emotion in the movement. Then you can write everything you have felt or you are still feeling towards somebody or towards yourself, and why you feel this, and what it can cause, etc., etc., etc. So, after writing this letter, you can throw it away, you can burn it, you can send it in the water, in the river, or some other things. So, but you will manage to put it out of yourself. The other possibility is to express it through singing or playing some musical instrument, and also through shouting or dancing. It's up to you, but these are so-called safe ways how to express any kind of emotion. Second part of our list is speaking about the depth of emotions, which means that we will speak what is better for ourselves to feel the emotion just a little bit or the shallow feeling, or to feel it really deeply. So when feeling the emotion just on the surface, so it's really shallow, it can be comfortable for you because you don't need to cope with the depth of the emotion. It can be comfortable for your surroundings if you are expressing your emotions directly. So it looks like from the outer point of view that the shallow feeling is better than the deep one. But there are also different, there is also different point of view when it's said that if the situation is really severe, bad, or extremely good, it's really good for ourselves to feel the emotion deeply. It's not good to stay in that state for a long time, in that depth, but it's good to know the whole depth of that emotion. It helps us to enrich our life, to enrich our feeling scale, and also it helps us understand the other people. So to this point, it's just this small input that the deep one is good one, but not staying for a long time in the depth of that emotion. Then we have the third point, which are changes between various kinds of emotions. It's natural that the changes between emotions happen during the day, during the week, or during the month or year. It's really natural for human being to change the mood, to change the emotions, but it's very important to find a way how to cope with emotion in the meaning that when we are going up and down and then to different parts of the emotions, then we don't stay, don't settle in that emotion. So changes are natural and it's really good to know how to go back to some, it's not a line, it's something like stripe, where you will stay for a longer time and where you can feel a so-called prosperous emotions, about which I will say something a little bit later. So the changes are natural. It's not good to stay in the depth of any emotion, as I have already mentioned in previous point. And the other thing, it's not good to settle in any emotion because when settling in that emotion, it can again cause some health problems, some mental problems. And I think nobody of you wants to have any health or mental problems. So it's natural to change the emotions, but try again to go back to your zone that is comfortable for you. Not comfortable, that is prosperous for you. And now the last point, what are prosperous and non-prosperous emotions? Why speaking about these two kinds of emotions? Because emotions are like fuel for our life. If there are no emotions, you have no fuel. It doesn't mean that you can't live, that you can't survive. You can, but it will be like some kind of diet that there is no taste. On the other side, if you will have emotions and they will fuel your life will be really full of many different things, and you can find which emotions helps you go further in your life, which emotions help you achieve your goals, your dreams, which emotions helps you to become a better man or woman, so that you can help yourself and probably also the others. So prosperous emotions are those that are supporting you on this way, that are helping you to go further, to fulfill your dreams, to become a better person. And on the other hand, non-prosperous emotions are those that are holding you back. Which emotions in which situations are prosperous and non-prosperous? It depends really on the situation, and you need to find out which emotion belongs to which category according to the situation you are right now in. And of course, it will change in the time. So the non-prosperous emotions in this situation can become prosperous emotions in the next situation. So it's really important to stop for a while and find out, yeah, now I'm in this situation. We have this, and this aspect. So if I want to go that direction, then I will need as a support this, and this emotion. I will try, and if it works, just continue. When the situation changes again, stop and do the same process again from the beginning. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for your attention, and start with your emotions as your allies, not your enemies. Thank you.